older guy on a motorbike.
He's likely to have some pretty nasty injuries. Oh.
You saw up here? Yeah.
He's in so much pain. There's definitely something really wrong.
It's very tender up there.
We need to find out what's causing all this pain.
Would you rescue me when I'm by myself? When I need your love, if I need your help, would you rescue me? Would you rescue me? But I start to wonder if I've slipping under. Oh, would you rescue me? Would you
give me? We've got a stabbing to the chest.
The bone's been smashed to bits.
Whoa!
He's actually stopped breathing.
We're going to look after you.
At the Royal Melbourne Hospital, the emergency department is one of Australia's busiest.
Lower back, anterior ribs.
With staff from all walks of life.
Red bag and yellow bag.
Including emergency doctor Jason Gabriel Anyasor.
Grew up in London and went to university in the northeast of England. I feel like I got a bit more satisfaction in the job over here in terms of how much more hands-on you can be. I think your work-life balance is better. Ended up staying, met an Australian girl, and then we've just had twin girls who are now 5.5 months old. Tiredness takes on a new, different level, but at the same time, you look at them and you're just so happy that all of that kind of melts into the background.
Do you know roughly how fast he would have been going?
Dr. Jason hears about his next trauma patient.
We're expecting a young male who's been involved in a motorbike or a dirt bike accident. He seems like he's in a lot of pain and needing a lot of medication for them to get him out of where he was.
The 17-year-old was competing in a dirt bike race when he had a spine-chilling fall.
Got it?
Yep.
Hugh is affected from pain medication paramedics gave the teenager.
This is Hugh, 17-year-old male. Hugh was riding his motorcycle and he's come off as he was going into a ditch over the handlebars and hit his pelvis basically on a mound. Instant pain in the pelvic region. Ambulance crews on scene described legs splayed out to the side.
Anytime someone's legs seem to be pointing in the wrong direction, we worry about fractures, dislocations. A bad pelvic fracture can be life-threatening. You can lose a lot of blood into your pelvis if it's not managed properly.
Excellent.
He's maybe feeling a bit scared and a bit uncertain of what's going on, so we just try our best to reassure him and let him know that he's safe and looked after.
Is Dad here yet or not?
Where's Dad coming from?
Where I fell off.
Hugh's dad was watching his son race. He stayed by his side until the chopper took off and is now on his way to the hospital.
No more dead bikes.
What do you do?
They now have the x-rays of Hugh's pelvis. But it's not giving Dr. Jason all the information he needs.
There's a couple of things that suggest perhaps there is something going on there. There's maybe a bit of widening of these joints and it looks a bit irregular around his sacroiliac region. Sometimes people with significant pelvic injuries, when you've got a binder on, the x-ray can look normal even if there is an injury because the binder is kind of holding everything together. Hi, Hugh.
Hi.
We're worried as to if you've broken your pelvis, your hip bones.
I have.
We're worried, so we're going to get you around for a CT scan to have a look at that, and we just want to make sure you've not got any other injuries from your head down to your hips as well, OK?
Along with his pelvis, the 17-year-old's dirt bike antics could have left him with any number of life-changing injuries.
We'll look for signs of any bleeding in his brain, any injuries in his chest, broken ribs, collapsed lungs, bleeding in the lungs, and any broken bones in his spine as well.
With patients streaming in, it's all hands on deck, including Deputy Director of the ED, Dr. Steve Pinkers.
One of the attractions of working in the ED is that it's different every day. That lack of sameness. You're going to get a different variety of patients.
Looks to be fairly under control here at the moment. It's not quiet. We've had 24 patients arrive in the last 2 hours.
Coming through the doors is a cyclist involved in a collision with a ute.
And one, two, three.
Nurse Elle Greenwood does Sam's initial assessments.
Sam, that's correct, yeah?
Yeah.
Do you remember what happened?
Yeah, I was just riding down Lonsdale Street. I saw the car and I thought he was going to halt and then kind of went for it and then I was a little bit too late.
Yeah.
Not your fault, though.
You didn't pass out at all?
No. I remember a lot of pain in my right leg and then just started groaning it out.
G'day. Steve's my name, I'm one of the doctors.
Oh, good to meet you.
I suspect you've had better days.
Oh, for sure, for sure.
He has a nasty broken femur, and that's got to hurt. To use the vernacular, the stiff upper lip, the person who can just grin and bear it. And those patients, they worry you a little because, you know, Sam is being incredibly stoic, but is he actually in a lot of pain and not telling me?
And out of 10, how sore is your leg?
And right now it's probably like a 2 or 1.
Okay, that's good. So the whistle's doing wonders.
Yeah.
Even with the green whistle paramedics gave him for pain relief, Sam's pain should be a lot worse.
Did you hit the side of the car or the front of the car?
Right in the corner of his bull bar.
That's a nasty place to hit.
Yeah.
Bull bars are designed to be basically something for pushing a large beast out of the way of a big car going fast. You've got a completely unprotected person being hit by something which is extremely hard.
Sam?
Yes?
Can you just have a few deep breaths for me, in and out through your nose?
Suddenly, there are signs everything's not okay.
Sam, we're just going to put some oxygen on you, okay?
For sure.
His oxygen levels have gotten a little lower than where we like them to be. If I make him anxious and he gets worried, that can complicate the scenario even more.
So they have those oxygen clinics in the LA and all that, all fancy.
Oh, fancy oxygen spots. I mean, I wish it was as bougie and as lush as that. If you want to pretend this is a bit of a oxygen spa retreat, then you're more than welcome to.
Yes, that's what I'll imagine in my head. Right,
imagine
now.
That.
While Sam continues putting on a brave face, Dr. Steve is worried about a serious complication.
If he bleeds from his femur into his thigh, the blood is now not available for the heart to pump it around. It's not available to provide carry oxygen to his brain, his other vital organs. You can end up having things like heart attacks and strokes and damage to other major organs without ever losing a drop of blood from your body.
The Royal Melbourne Emergency Department, cyclist Sam is in remarkably good spirits for someone who's been hit by a ute.
I heard that these brakes are usually like agonizing pain, so
yes.
You guys have done a great job so far.
Well, I think you're doing the great job.
It's lovely to receive a compliment. It doesn't happen all the time and it's extremely appreciated and it definitely makes my day a lot more memorable and makes that person a lot more memorable.
Now, I know about your right leg, that's quite obvious. Are you sore anywhere else?
No.
Okay.
No, I can't really feel anything.
Right. Well, look, check out from top to bottom. You're not sore along there at all?
No.
Dr. Steve thinks Sam's chatter is his way of taking his mind off his painful injury.
Not sore at all anywhere there?
No.
Okay.
Some people experience pain extremely emotionally. And they express that emotionally. Other people can internalise their pain and continue to operate with quite significant levels of pain.
Big sting, mate.
And while Sam's not complaining, Dr. Steve decides to inject his badly broken leg with a nerve block.
What that involves is putting local anaesthetic around the femoral nerve, which is the big nerve right up in the top of his leg and supplies most of the sensation to your thigh. The advantage of that is I can give him good pain relief without affecting his conscious state.
Okay. That block should take about sort of 5-10 minutes to start to work.
Sure.
If you need something, let us know, okay?
Yeah, will do.
Sam's being prepped for x-rays and scans on his broken femur.
You've got major blood vessels running down your leg, right close to the bone there. And, you know, you damage them, you can get some really significant bleeding.
Does your wife know you're here?
Yes. She asked if you needed to come down, and I was like, I'm sure the doctors have it.
Yeah, I'm the nurse.
I'm the nurse, it's true.
So I'm going to sound a little mean, but you won't be able to eat or drink anything until we've got your scans and the results and can sit you up, OK?
That's quite all right. I'm sure my wife would like me to lose the weight.
Oh, I don't know. That's probably not what she's thinking right now. Well, I hope not.
I think Sam's personality is extremely stoic and he doesn't want to worry anyone, including his wife, who's probably the one person who is allowed to worry.
Sam's x-rays reveal the extent of his injury.
He's broken it about one third of the way up from his knee. And it's basically a straight across fracture from where he hit the bull bar, or the bull bar hit him. And it's just literally like a shearing force going straight across, and it's just snapped the bone.
The good news is there's no damage to Sam's blood vessels surrounding the thigh bone, but he needs a major operation to fix it.
What they're going to do is they will be putting a nail, literally looks like a really big stainless steel nail, and they're going to put that through the centre of the bone, along the marrow space.
But after surgery, Sam will have a long recovery.
Is there a chance that Sam could end up with a limp or other problems for the rest of his life? Yeah, absolutely.
Unfortunately, Sam's accident today is an all too familiar one in the ED.
We see a lot of cyclists. The problem with cyclists is they are unprotected, and cars, even small cars, are big and they're heavy and they have an awful lot of energy. And when they hit you, they do a lot of damage.
Over in the CT scanner, 17-year-old dirt bike competitor Hugh is being scanned after crashing spectacularly in a race. Suddenly, Hugh takes a turn for the worse. The team moves quickly. They roll him to stop him choking.
Often, either because of their injuries or the medications they've had to manage the pain, people get sick and vomit.
And so how much ketamine?
Well, had 30 milligrams by the time he came round here.
Okay.
The other thing we worry about is whether the medications he's had make him a bit drowsy, so his breathing is less effective than it would normally be, so he's not taking as big deep breaths because he's sleepy from the medications.
With the CT scans completed, the nurses do what they can to make you feel a little better and a little less full of dirt.
All right, I'm gonna try and clean up the face. Right. That feels slightly better.
It's going to be a long cleanup job.
I know.
I think he was after a phone to try and let his parents know.
Even when it takes time for their families to get down, it's nice that we can at least facilitate things like a phone call so that Hugh can talk to his parents.
It's an accident which has affected him both physically and emotionally. As the day goes on, the emergency department is still juggling an unusually high number of patients, and there's barely anywhere to put them.
Is there someone seeing this trauma?
What trauma?
Well, it says there's a guy who's fallen 3 metres coming in here.
Emergency doctor Maya Cubitt is on the hunt for a man who's just arrived after a serious work accident.
I've had a phone call about a 20-year-old man who's had a fall from a ladder. I'm trying to find him and I'm not really sure where he is.
Yeah. You've seen him in the corridor.
The mystery's solved and Dr. Maya goes in the direction of the patient with Registrar Dr. Matt Bray, who's a proud new addition to the emergency team.
You see it in the specialists I work with in the emergency department, of really great humanists who are practicing emergency medicine with such compassion and excellence and commitment to really getting fantastic outcomes for the patient.
Is this the gentleman that fell off the ladder?
Yeah.
Oh, go to the CT scanner. They're ready for him.
Oh,
yeah. Sometimes, weirdly, the imaging department are ready to do things before we've had even a chance to find a bed for the patient. And things don't normally happen in this sequence, but someone's decided that a trauma scan is required, and the radiology department is ready to do the scan.
Josh, an apprentice electrician, is fast-tracked to CT because he's fallen nearly 3 metres from a ladder. Dr. Matt is using a special dye to better pinpoint his injuries.
I'm going to put in a drip,
yep,
this contrast so that we can see all the organs. Make sure it's not bleeding or anything like that. Just worried when you fell from such a height.
The dye is delivered through a cannula, and Dr. Matt relies on ultrasound to guide the thin tube.
I like to think I'm pretty slick at cannulas most of the time, but Josh has took a couple of attempts. In the end, I needed to bring an ultrasound around to cannulate him in the CT scanner.
While Josh goes into the scanner, his girlfriend Meg has arrived at the hospital.
It's very hard not being able to see your loved ones, and that's the most stressful thing, is not being able to just be there for them. He doesn't like to tell me what's fully going on, just to make sure that I don't stress out so much. But like, they have given me a few updates and stuff and kept his mum updated. The main thing is the fact that I haven't been able to see him yet.
Dr. Matt waits to see what injuries the 20-year-old has suffered in such a big fall.
From the head injury side of things, the CT scan looks okay, so we're just processing the rest of the imaging. The greatest risk for him is a serious spinal injury that might, you know, result in serious disability for Josh.
It's Jonathan, perhaps an emergency? Yeah, I'll do that.
Today, trauma patients are just rolling in one after another.
They might just be easy to be seen out in the ambulance corridor.
Solving problems here, there and everywhere is senior emergency doctor Jonathan Papson.
Do you want a chest x-ray?
Good idea.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a bit like being a band leader. My job is to speed the slow ones up and slow down the fast ones and turn down some things that are a little bit loud and maybe put a bit more emphasis on something else. So it's a bit like that, I guess. Yeah, that's a nice analogy.
Motorcyclist flew through the air, right shoulder ribs.
Do it as a trauma alert.
Yeah.
A patient is coming in with severe chest and shoulder pain after an off-road motorbike accident.
I better tell Michelle the bad news. We're on again, another trauma.
Emergency doctor Michelle Thornhill was hoping for a break.
You know that little thing about lunch and all that sort of stuff?
Is that not going to happen?
Well, Trina's got a really unwell patient in recess 5.
I used to know because I'm a bit dehydrated and hypoglycemic, but that's great.
She's just a little bit antsy. I can tell she wants to go and eat her lunch. It's an older guy on a motorbike crash with shoulder, chest pain.
Okay, I could do it. Sure. I'm tough.
Yeah. I know you're tough.
Unfortunately, lunch is not the priority. We sometimes try to make it the priority, but we don't always succeed.
Motorbike riders who have shoulder and rib pain often have multiple rib fractures, punctured lung. Sometimes they kind of die at the scene. He hasn't died at the scene. That's good. But as you get older, you start breaking ribs, you do worse. Essentially, your mortality goes up. Can you get me some morphine and ketamine?
Yeah.
We might have to put a chest tube in, worst case scenario, or relocate a shoulder or something like that.
How's everyone?
Excellent. Good, thank you.
He's got a very fractured right shoulder. But it's going to be a bit of a move to get him across. All right, this is Tony, 67 years old. He was traveling on a dirt track, probably about 80 km an hour on a motorbike. He's come over the crest of a hill. The tree has been down. He's hit the tree. He's probably gone a good 15 meters in the air, where he's landed on his shoulder, and his bike has come tumbling after him.
Tony's lucky to have survived this accident and made it here. Because being 67, you can be susceptible to pretty significant injury from a high-impact fall.
You're just going to feel some cold gel while I do a quick ultrasound on the chest and the tummy.
Dr. Michelle is doing an ultrasound, checking for internal bleeding.
A little bit on your lungs here.
Tony's, these arms all.
Can't tell.
Oh, shoulder is. Any shoulder on your right hand side is the one that's sore, right?
Everything's sore at the moment.
What do you think, Dr. Thornhill?
So far, okay.
The ultrasound is clear, but Dr. Michelle is still concerned.
Is it okay here? That's sore there. Up there. Okay, all right. No problem.
Where was that?
The shoulder.
He's in so much pain that something must be broken. But just looking at his shoulder, I can't see anything looking really wrong.
What's wrong with that arm?
Well, he's very sore in the shoulder there.
But it's not dislocated?
I don't think so.
Not broken?
I don't think it is, no.
No. It's strange.
The 67-year-old bike rider is in a lot of pain after being flung 15 metres off his trail bike. Dr. Michelle needs to pinpoint why he's so sore, and quickly.
The older you are, the less reserve that your body has. So it's really important to get on top of things quickly before they run away from us.
Two, three. Oh, there we go.
Could we get some decks? Four of deck?
In trauma one, dirt bike rider Hugh is overcome with nausea, the effects of his pain medication.
I know, it feels horrible. You're doing really well.
Nurse Gemma Hodgson is keeping the teenager's head as still as possible, as he may have spinal injuries.
Feel a bit better after you've chucked?
Yeah.
Yeah, you generally do, don't you? Try not to move your head too much, all right?
How are you doing there, Hugh?
Dr. Jason is caring for the 17-year-old who took a heavy fall on his dirt bike during a race.
You think you're good to roll back now?
Yeah.
All right, we'll go back on three. One, two, three. You're doing really well. Oh, this is the boy with all the mud. Might have to roll you a little bit the other side. You don't do anything, just to get all this stuff out, okay? On three. One, two, three.
Emergency Dr. Michael Dunn has a spare moment, so he too gets in and helps remove the muddy sheets.
How many doctors does it take to make a bed?
The situation Hugh's currently in is quite scary. It'd be scary for anyone, let alone a 17-year-old. So if we as nurses and doctors and healthcare providers can provide any sort of levity to the situation to keep him calm, it's what we love to do.
Your parents are here.
Hugh's parents, David and Marita, finally make it to their son's bedside.
Hey, bud. You're going to be going to sleep, do you? You want to sleep?
Oh.
Yeah, within a couple of 100 metres, a guy came up to me and said, is that Hugh, your son? And I said, yes, and he said he'd come off badly, and so I just took off. The ambulance, luckily, were right there at that obstacle, which was very fortunate for us, yeah.
For Hugh and his parents, it's a waiting game, with the CT results still to come.
You have these moments where you think of the worst, and then you think, no, just stay calm, because it might not be much. So, yeah, that's pretty much what I was sticking to. Yeah.
The scan results are in, and they're not what Dr. Jason is expecting.
Hugh's scans all look pretty normal. We can't find any evidence of any injuries. His pelvis looks okay, so he doesn't seem to have suffered any major traumatic injuries.
His parents, too, are amazed. Their young daredevil has had a very lucky escape.
At this point, it seems like a positive outcome. The initial scans are looking positive. Fingers crossed that he's okay, and fingers crossed that he doesn't race anymore.
It doesn't look deformed, but it's very tender. It might just be like neck of humerus or...
It's a day of bike injuries in the ED. In Tony's case, it was a motorbike accident on a trail that has landed him in Dr. Michelle's care.
How would you describe the pain?
Oh, it's very stinging on the right hand side.
In the shoulder or the chest?
And down the other as well.
The 67-year-old was riding through the bush when he hit a fallen tree and was thrown 15 metres in the air before landing heavily on his shoulder. His friend Rover was following on his trail bike.
It really occurred to me how it was bad luck, because where the crest was and where the tree was, you didn't see the tree until the last minute, and I was lucky to pull up, but Tone obviously didn't have that luck. But once you get over the fact that you find him and that you're not dealing with a death, which was my first concern, he wasn't moving. Jumped off the bike and said, "Are you okay?" And he said, "Yeah, I can't breathe, get the helmet off." So I quickly ran over to him and helped him get his helmet off, which was probably the wrong thing to do, but he said he couldn't breathe.
Both Dr. Michelle and Dr. Jonathan are expecting the x-rays to reveal multiple injuries.
It's still a bit puzzling. We're looking at the x-rays and where there should be a fracture or a dislocation, we can't see it. So still scratching our heads at the moment, and we're not giving up just yet.
Oh, sore ribs there.
Sore ribs on this side.
Still not sure what's wrong with Tony. One thing they have to rule out are spinal injuries.
I'm sorry, mate.
It's shoulder. Right.
Yeah, it's okay. Just, let's do this, and then we're going to get some pain medication into you, okay?
Are you sore up here?
So it's strange that he's come off his motorbike, gone down an embankment, and amazingly, he doesn't have any tenderness in his spine.
Great job.
One, two, three. Tells us that there are no obvious fractures causing him pain, but it could still be a concern.
That's really sore.
And your belly.
Yeah. I need another hobby.
As smashed up as he is, Tony's thinking of his dog Riley, knowing his best mate will be wondering where he is.
That's my dog.
What's your dog with you?
Someone
at home?
No. My wife's bike.
I'm sorry about that.
Yes,
Even though Tony's in a bad way, he's focusing on his family. And his family for him is his dog, who he loves very much. And his thoughts are with his wife, who unfortunately passed away some time ago. He's stable enough that we can get him to the CT scanner now.
Dr. Michelle needs to get to the bottom of all Tony's pain. With the x-rays not showing any fractures, a CT scan will tell her what she still suspects are serious injuries.
With the amount of pain that Tony's in his chest, I'm concerned about damage to his spine and nerves, also possible puncture of his lungs and any bleeding he may have internally.
In the emergency department, 67-year-old Tony is having CT scans after crashing badly while riding his motorbike on a bush trail.
The biggest problems we see with motorbike accidents are broken bones, like the pelvis, because it can cause a lot of bleeding internally that we can't stop immediately, and things like the spinal column, because that can cause long-lasting effects with damage to the spinal cord.
Three hospital guys give you an indication of what the mechanism was.
So it had a fallen tree, flown 15 metres over, hit the ground and then formed out a massive bank.
Okay, so it could have impacted anything.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Something must be broken. Either his arm bone or his scapula or his collarbone. He's in that much pain that I would think at least one, if not more, bones are broken. We just need to look at the whole picture and see what's going on.
Dr. Michelle now has the CT scan results.
Ah. Now it becomes clearer. Hi there, Tony. I just wanted to give you the update from the CT scan reports. No obvious injury to your neck, which is great. What you have broken, though, is your shoulder blade or scapula on that left side.
The left side?
On the left side.
Why is the right side then?
Well, you've probably sprained it. Well, don't move it around too much. You've probably sprained it and there'll be some bruising of the muscle. He may have actually torn some ligaments or tendons or muscles in that area. And they also may be damaged to nerves going to the shoulder. So it's hard to know for sure at this point. A lot of things on the left side, plus some rib fractures. And in your back, so the lower vertebrae, they've broken as well.
Shit.
All right.
Ah! Oh. That's what I'm...
Sorry.
This feels just like a broken bone, because broken bones...
Yeah.
When you touch them, they hurt.
Okay. So it's not this... Oh. I'm not touching, just looking. Oh, yeah, it's interesting, because yeah, I've had a look too, and they can't see anything broken there. Okay. All right, Tony, take care. His next steps are to be admitted to the ward. The trauma doctors will look after him. The orthopedic doctors will also need to be involved because he may require surgery for his broken bones.
Now that Tony's taken care of, Dr. Michelle might finally get that long overdue lunch break.
Lunch?
You're inviting me again?
No.
That was the lunch you
didn't
have.
Stay and work. I can go.
Okay.
Receive some nourishment.
All right, good. Go, enjoy.
Okay, I'm going to run.
Don't have a degustation menu. Just a normal lunch, right? I do need you back.
Over in the CT, 20-year-old Josh is waiting to find out what damage has been done to his back after a serious fall.
Beautiful. Thank you very much.
Happy.
Thank you, CT team.
Thank you.
It'll take a bit more time to sift through the images.
Okay, now it's the waiting game.
Yeah.
Okay, so... As long as you're comfortable,
yep.
You're basically waiting for all your results to come back.
Yes.
Okay. Josh was climbing off a ladder onto a roof when he took that one wrong step.
The ladder was set up and I put one foot on the roof and then my back leg obviously had all the weight of it when I took my leg off to go onto the roof and then the ladder slid out from the weight, I guess. Gave way and then I fell. Just happened so fast that I just dropped. I tried grabbing on to the roof, but I missed it.
I'm very closely scrutinizing the CT scans that look at his vertebrae to see that there's no bony injuries that might result in serious disability for Josh.
I think it's got like 1-2 mils anterior.
Show me the scans.
Dr. Matt gets a second opinion from Dr. Meyer, concerned about what he's looking at.
Is there another view? Ah, holy moly.
Right, pain all good?
In the emergency department, Josh's fall from a ladder could mean a debilitating back injury.
Just hopefully it goes well. It's just the stress of not knowing. Yeah, that's all.
Dr. Matt and Dr. Meyer are going through the images in minute detail, believing the apprentice electrician must have suffered some sort of spinal injuries in the fall.
Oh, what?
Dr. Matt spots a tiny break that could have been easily missed.
Minimally displaced propulsion into the pipe.
So he's got a fracture through that whole vertebral body, doesn't he?
Yeah.
So you'd miss that if you were just looking at that view.
Absolutely.
But if you combine it with that view.
It's really, really nice to work in a team of people, especially registrars who are really keen to do a good job, to give good care, even with the challenges that we've got at the moment that include, you know, examining people in a corridor. I think Matt's done an amazing job.
This is why registrars look at scans, because they pick things. Good for you. Well done.
Dr. Matt can now tell Josh what the pain in his lower back is all about.
Josh, a fall from that height, you put yourself at risk of injuring a lot of things, and thankfully you didn't hit your head.
Yeah.
So, one of your vertebrae gets fractured.
Yeah.
And that the top part of it's just shifted a few millimetres forward.
Okay.
I don't on the face of it think it's going to be something that needs big surgery or anything like that.
It doesn't.
Josh will be admitted under the trauma service. He's going to need input from the orthopaedic spinal surgeons who will know precisely what precautions he needs to take. Thankfully, Josh has come away all right. But be careful out there on the ladders, people.
...37-year-old cyclist Sam badly fractured his leg when a ute crashed into him on his way to work.
Did you hit the side of the car or the front of the car?
Right in the corner of his wall bar.
But the IT consultant appeared to be able to distract himself from his injury, chatting away to Nurse L.
If you want to pretend this is an oxygen spa retreat, then you're more than welcome to.
That's what I'll imagine in my head.
Imagine that.
Sam was taken immediately to surgery to fix his broken leg. 2 days after his accident, he's recovering from his operation.
Yeah, I'm doing well. Yeah, I mean, all things considering I was hit by a car with a bull bar.
Surgeons stabilised his broken femur with some impressive hardware.
They've managed to insert a titanium rod. So it's quite spectacular that ever since Thursday till now, I'm actually already starting to be on crutches.
Sam should be back walking in 3 months, his cheery disposition intact.
You know, these things happen. That's part of life.
Dirt bike rider Hugh was rushed by air ambulance to emergency after a terrifying fall during a race.
Over the handlebars and hit his pelvis basically on a mount.
Dr. Jason suspected a broken pelvis.
There's a couple of things that suggest perhaps there is something going on there.
Sore and shaken, the 17-year-old seemed to be having second thoughts about ever getting on a bike again. Remarkably, Hugh didn't have any serious injuries and was well enough to go home the next day.
From an injuries perspective, there's nothing to say that he can't ride a dirt bike again, except maybe his promise to his mum.
Dr. Matt's patient, Josh, fell nearly 3 metres at work.
So I was getting on a roof of a spray booth and the ladder was set up and I put 1 foot on the roof and then the ladder slid out and then I fell onto my lower back.
Josh was lucky to escape major injury.
One of your vertebrae gets fractured.
Yeah.
I don't on the face of it think it's going to be something that needs big surgery or anything like that.
Josh is slowly recovering. But it'll take some time before he can return to work. Dr. Michelle's patient, 67-year-old Tony, crashed his motorbike on a bush track.
He's in so much pain that something must be broken.
Oh, I'm sorry, mate.
CT results showed he came off second best when his bike hit a fallen tree, throwing Tony 15 metres into the air.
What you have broken, though, is your shoulder blade or scapula on that left side.
The left side?
On the left side.
Tony spent 3.5 weeks in hospital and rehab before being allowed back home. And he had more than just a broken shoulder blade.
I have 4 fractured vertebrae, 5 broken ribs, and a fractured left scapula. They're the breaks.
Tony's happy to be back with his dog, Riley.
Yeah, I missed him a hell of a lot.
While he's still in pain, the bike enthusiast is keen to get back in the saddle, even if he's not quite up to trail bike riding yet.
A bit lower to the ground, so that'll be a bit easier to handle.
I got the clearance 2 days ago from the hospital, so I've got no restrictions now. I can go on a motorbike, and guess what? I'm going to get in the motorbike and go. How about that?